Welcome to another blurry vlog. Good morning, kind of, not really, it's one. I didn't vlog yesterday because I went to my aunt's house and we had, like, you know, some family time. And as I mentioned earlier, I'm trying to not vlog all of my days and spend some off-camera quality time with my friends and family. My voice is randomly gone. Not that that's anything unique or different, because my voice randomly disappears all the damn time. Today is an intense work day. I know I always say that, but today I'm actually, for the first time, overwhelmed. Not first time, but extremely overwhelmed. Last night I was supposed to stay up really late and work, and I went to bed at like 10 p.m. and didn't wake back up. So I severely effed myself over, and now I have a stupid amount of things to do today, and I'm really stressed, and I'm kind of in trouble from people because, like, I've missed deadlines or things. People are like, hi, we're supposed to have this, and I was like, I'm so sorry. And I'm trying to catch up. The first thing I'm doing is watching the third cut of the 82 UI movie. So after three rounds of notes, I need to give, you know, either sign off on it or give some more notes, and so I'm about to do that. Then I just have a bazillion other things to do today, so it's gonna be a very work day. We're gonna be trapped in this room. I'm locking myself in this room, and that is what's going to happen. And no, I haven't had a chance to buy another vlog camera yet. I'm sorry. Let's do it. I had to stop watching the movie and tell you that it's snowing outside. There's snow falling out. There's snow outside. What the casca what? Ferme la bouche, mama nature. The F. Where your ass flat, dog, niggas one feet. Where your ass flat, dog, bitches 10 feet. Where your ass flat, dog, niggas try to run off. Where your ass flat, dog, made me put his gun out. Where your ass flat, dog, when the switch sides. So minor detail, whatever. Speaking of which, yo, no, whatever, yo. Listen, so yesterday, right, I posted a picture wearing my OVO 10s, you know, Drake's shoes that collab he did with Jordan and stuff, and I posted it on Instagram and stuff, and this morning, whatever, not only did Drake like the picture, but Drake followed me on Instagram. Mother effa, hey! Mother effa, hey! Hotline bling, say, whoa! That's right, Drake followed me on Instagram. Hey! Six guns, 6 months ever. Wagwan popcorns. It is 5:30 p.m. I am going good with the work. Everything's going well. I still got a lot more things to do on my to-do list, but I've done a decent amount, which I'm very happy about. Pat on my back. It's 5:30, and it looks like it's midnight outside. It's so pitch black. It's like literally my least favorite thing about winter is how dark it gets so early. By like 4:30, I'm like, because it feels like it's midnight. But that's the situation right now. Would have been mine again, baby. Hey, I know my lifestyle is driving you crazy. So let's have a sentimental moment. I just edited the vlog from 2 days ago where my friend surprised me with a pink limo, and I like had a hard time editing it. I was like, this is really emotional. And yesterday at my aunt's house, my sister-in-law legit got like teary-eyed talking to me, and I was like, you know what it is? Like, I know I'm gonna come back so often, but now it's starting to really hit me that, like, still things will change. And I remember when I was out with my girls, you know, I was talking to Sheena, and she's like, so, like, you're only going for, like, 6 months, right? And I was like, Sheena, no, I'm moving there. My apartment is just a 6-month rental, but, like, during that time, I'm gonna look for another place to buy. And she's like, wait, like, what do you mean? And I'm like, I'm moving, babe, like, permanently. The only way I would come back is if I, like, hate it, but I have plans to live there. And she's just like, wait, what? And I think at that moment, it kind of was like, holy crap, this is a real thing. And it's been really hitting me. And I think the next week or so, I'm going to be super emotional because, yeah, you know, I travel so much. I think I've convinced myself that you travel so much anyways. It's not going to be any different. But I always come back home. Even if I'm gone for like a month or 2 months, I always come back home. But now home will be an empty apartment in LA with no family. And I think that's, like, a thing for me. It's a thing. Like, I'm probably gonna sell my car. I'm not gonna live here. Frig. And I think everyone's gonna get really emotional, including myself. And I'm, like, in a state of denial where I haven't even booked my ticket yet. And, like, people are like, who's going with you to LA? Because it's gonna be very hard for you to, like, travel with all your stuff. And, you know, Chase and Sandy both offered to, like, fly with me, and I just haven't responded to them yet because I'm just avoiding it. Like, my brain is like, no, avoid it. I'm kind of on the fence because I'm like, at the same time, I want people to come with me because I'm gonna have all this stuff. It's gonna be so hard for me to transport, and help would be great. But on the other side of that, I kind of don't want anyone to come with me because I feel like it'll make me more emotional. Like, I already told my parents they definitely cannot come with me because I'm used to leaving the house, and I can do that.
But if I go to a new place and my parents don't, then they leave me alone there, I think that will like really be devastating for me. And I think it'll be the same with my friends. Like, I think I need to deal with it, go there, cry, and kind of address it. But if my friends are there and that goodbye is like lingering, I think that'll make it more difficult. But I'm still deciding. I have no idea. But that's kind of where I'm at. I'm not looking forward to my going away thing. I'm not looking forward to any of that, because even if I convince myself, everyone else will be very... I'm so scared. Frig. I'm really friggin' scared. Watching Selena slay the AMAs right now. Slay. I'm just literally watching her one performance. Queen! Oh, she gonna dance? Oh, she gonna dance? I love her. I just love her. It's still like me watching her perform. It's as if like my younger sister is performing. Like, that's how panicked and nervous I feel. As if like a dear friend, younger sister was performing. I'm so protective. I'm like, oh, stairs. Watch it, baby girl. Baby, there's stairs. Like, I'm so, I just want her to do so well all the time. It's like a thing. Kill it, queen. What's up? About to open my phone. I've been in denial and haven't opened it yet, even though it has a functioning number and everything. I'm gonna open it now because I've decided I'm an adult and I've made this decision and now I need to act upon it. So, opening my new phone. Should I do like one of those unboxing videos? I never understood them. Like, here we have the white box and you see it has a rose gold apple, all right? Apparently those keep the doctor away. She smells pretty bad. This is dope. I was hesitant to get the iPhone 6 because I was like, how am I gonna text people like this? But I had to get a new phone, so I got the rose gold, which is kind of, oh, it's really pretty. I really like it. And I don't have a case for it yet, so I need to get a case for tomorrow. But this is the box, and if you see and you open, you have the headphones that no one ever uses, and the thing that everyone always loses, and the charger that will last approximately 2 weeks. How's that for an honest iPhone review? Although, I love iPhone. iPhone till I die. Love them so much. This is my new phone, and oh my god, am I gonna take the plastic off? You know, I hate taking the plastic off new things. I'm like that Indian that hates doing that crap. Like, it is really pretty, actually. Okay. Just looking at flights, and I just clicked one way and got stabbed in the heart. I clicked one way. There's no return flight. I clicked one way. Okay. So I couldn't get myself to book the ticket today. Hopefully tomorrow I will have that courage. I just want to check a few timing things with my parents. Some kind of news is that I messaged King to be like, are you going to be there December 1st to like help me and pick me up and stuff? And unfortunately he's in New York, so he's not going to be there. And now I'm like, I don't know anyone else with a Jeep or anyone else that would be able to like help me out like that. Should I take a friend? I'm so confused. I don't know what to do. I don't know. I'm gonna think about it tomorrow. Too much for one day. I know today we just kind of sat in the room and did nothing, but that was my day. And I apologize in advance for the next week of me being a little bit of a mess. It might get a little bit repetitive, but this is a thing for me. This is like a thing. And even though it's on my vision board, it's scary. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Having your dreams come true is wonderful. It's also horrifying. It is absolutely horrifying. Okay, stop. Get a grip, okay? Today is past 12. Today is my nephew's second birthday. My pride and joy, his birthday. And so I'm gonna go to his house tomorrow. There's also video day tomorrow, and there's also work day tomorrow. So all those things are happening, and I'm gonna go to bed. Thank you for joining me on another day. There's a pimple forming right here, so I'm sure when we wake up, there'll be a new friend there. So, hello in advance. And I hope you had a great day, and tomorrow's another day. Yes! If you like it, subscribe.